Now we're gonna be doing whatever else we could find on here.
If I'm going to stop this killer, I should analyze the body I found on the rooftop of the Gotham Herald.
I thought for sure you were going to tell him. Come clean like you did with Gordon. Ah, but you realized, why break him now when we can crush him later? It's classic Joker. Something truly beautiful is happening, Bats. Cave of a mind, and it seems like you actually believe it's cure nonsense. Oh, Bruce, forget about the cure. You just concentrate on taking out the Arkham Knight. It'll be your swan song. The last good thing you'll ever do. Another body. The mutilation pattern looks to be identical to the previous murder victim.
Yes, Gotham does indeed have a serial killer in its midst. But here I was thinking this evening couldn't get any worse.
I'm going to scan the body for unique identifiers. Scar tissue on the upper arm. I recognize the pattern. 20 years ago, this was a badge of honor among inmates at Blackgate Penitentiary. A small group of racketeers known as the Bloodhaven Six. Remnants of a pacemaker fitted through the right ventricle. If I cross-reference the manufacturer with the pacing method, it will help to narrow the search.
You okay? You okay?
Clear signs of bone deformation on the victim's knee. Joint line sclerosis points to juvenile arthritis, a rare and debilitating condition. Alfred, I've ID'd the victim as Frank Cargo.
His records are a litany of drug-related offenses, sir. In and out of prison from an early age. He was serving a 20-year sentence at Blackgate before being released early on grounds of ill health due to a heart condition. He moved to Little Rock, Arkansas, which is where he was reported missing.
Another person taken from outside the Gotham area.
A significant detail, sir.
So are these words written beside the bodies. Try and find a connection between the two victims I've found, Alfred. There has to be something linking them together.
I'll try my best, sir.
The killer is mutilating and posing his victims and then putting them on display.
He left opera music playing at the crime scene. He wants them to be found.
Creature was once a man, Dr. Kirk Langstrom. There must be a cause for this transformation. His lab might hold the answer.
Proceed with caution, sir. The creature could still be hiding in familiar surroundings.
Folks?
No, my dog. My dog. What's my fate?
Start again.
Hello, world. Now let's go.
Come on, just be yourself.
Okay. Full genetic resplicing.
There's a computer. Maybe it contains some answers. This computer stores all of Dr. Langstrom's research. Through his files, I may be able to create an antidote to his condition. I need to isolate the man Beth's signature and remove it from Langstrom's DNA.
You're welcome.
Crazy out there, right, Boo Boo?